Welcome back to the LA Coliseum. Spectacular day, and this is Fox College Football. Fair this afternoon, the fourth-ranked team in the land, the Oregon Ducks, prepare to take on Lane Kiffin's USC Trojans.
Welcome to LA, where after being ranked number one during the preseason, the Trojans have fallen short on expectations, losing at Stanford and last week against Arizona. So, CD, here's their opportunity to win a big game.
They can still win the Pac-12 title. Obviously, it starts tonight against the best team they've played so far, against their nemesis, the team that's won three straight Pac-12 championships, and that's Oregon. They beat Oregon at Oregon last year, and most of the same playmakers are still in place for USC. Matt Barkley's still here. Marquise Lee's still here. Robert Woods is still here. Can USC make the winning plays, offense, defense? We'll find that out this evening.
Meanwhile, Chip Kelly told us that this USC team is the most talented team that they faced this season. So that begs the question, if USC can hang with them and get deep into the fourth quarter, how will the Ducks respond?
Similar to a boxing match, you want to take him deep into the rounds and see what he has, because Oregon is used to blowing people out. They would love to continue that formula. But if they get to the fourth quarter, USC wants to try and rattle their young quarterback, their freshman sensation, Marcus Mariota, who's played so well. Can he handle things in the Coliseum late in the fourth quarter with the game on the line? USC wants to test that theory.
Thanks so much, guys. Coach, all of the focus this week has been on last week's loss. How do you get these guys focused and ready to go up against Oregon?
Well, they're ready to go. This is a great opponent coming in here, obviously. Very good in all three phases of the game. It's going to be an awesome day in front of a great crowd.
Now, what did you stress to these guys before they took the field? Was there a message that you really want them to remember in this game?
Yeah, play with great composure. Don't let the energy get to you. Make really good decisions. Come back to the sideline and do it again and again and again. It's a heavyweight championship fight today.
Thank you so much. Good luck to you.
All right, thank you very much. As we take a look at the series note, this is the ninth straight meeting in which both teams are ranked. USC leads the series. However, Oregon has won 7 of the last 12. So back deep to Black Mamba, number 6, DeAnthony Thomas, along with Keenan Lowe. DeAnthony Thomas played his high school football right around the corner at Crenshaw High here in LA. Andre Hadari ready to send it away for SC. And we're underway from LA. And this one into the end zone for a touchback. Oregon will start from the 25.
As mentioned, DeAnthony Thomas, he'll play from the running back and slot position. Deion Jordan was beat up a little bit last week against Colorado. We'll see if he can go. A terrific pass rusher, Avery Patterson, has played well at safety. And Ifo Ekpre Olamu has been a tremendous corner. For New York, for USC, Marquise Lee should be a Heisman Trophy candidate. Deion Bailey, Hayes Pollard, and TJ McDonald have to contain the heavy run game of Oregon. USC is in for big trouble.
First down to 10 of the 25. Mariota to throw on first down. And he has his receiver, Josh Huff, the junior. Marcus Mariota, first freshman to start at quarterback for Oregon since Danny O'Neill in 1991. Second down and one. They hand it off. Barner straight ahead. He crosses the 40 up to the 41-yard line. Tackled by Deion Bailey. Also, Anthony Brown in on the play.
Notice early Oregon in the backfield. You've got DeAnthony Thomas on the field, and Mariota, who's been so tremendous as a quarterback, gives you a third running threat with Barner and Thomas. Mariota also uses his legs quite well.
Now he pulls it down, rolls out of the pocket, throws on the run. He has up. He juggled it. And they're going to call this a catch at the 30-yard line.
And if you're USC, you want it reviewed right away because of the juggling, but I think they got it right. Huff, as he was juggling it and bringing it in, kept the foot in bounds. Well done by Huff on the sideline.
That's a 30-yard game. Mariota now finding his tight end, Colt Lierla. Hayes Pollard with the tackle.
And look how fast Oregon wants to go now. Everyone getting to their positions quickly. In the red zone, they have been lethal all season long. 39 touchdowns in 49 possessions.
Gain of 8, opening drive for Oregon. Mariota firing, lofting it. Touchdown, the Black Mamba. And just like that, Oregon opens up and scores on their opening drive. DeAnthony Thomas.
And Oregon called the game in reverse early. They are a heavy run team with their spread. They came out throwing the football, moving at a fast pace. Never let USC get set and confident on defense. And be aware, they don't mind going for two out of this formation.
The Ducks, as you always say, Charles, playing with NASCAR-type speed. They go on a five-play, 75-yard drive. Not only does he want to blow out USC, he may have to.
The way things are shaping up with the computers, they need to have convincing wins down the stretch, even though they're going to play quality opponents.
Marquise Lee on the sideline. Lee trying to get outside. He crosses the 20, flag on the play. So that will back the Trojans up even more. So Matt Barkley came into this season as the front runner for the Heisman Trophy. Last year against Oregon, he was 26 of 34, 323, four touchdowns and a pick.
And has to play with a longer field. What did Lane Kiffin tell our Julie Alexandrian pregame? He wants a clean game. Go out and play without these penalties. Play without the mistakes.
First down and 10 at their own 12 for Matt Barkley. Out of the shotgun. High snap, handle. Barkley sprints out, throws on the run, and caught. Robert Woods, who's been plagued by a tender ankle dating back to last year. It's hampered him a bit this year, according to Lane Kiffin yesterday.
What I want to see is with these great receivers of USC, I fully expect the corners and the nickelbacks who have to come up and press them to do exactly that. I don't expect there to be a lot of room for USC to maneuver with their receivers. I think they're going to bring pass rush and put pressure on the receivers and force them to make extra moves downfield to try and beat them.
5 yard gain, second and five. Silas Red out of the offset eye. They give it to him. Red with a running room. And Silas Red up the sideline, and Silas Red crosses the 35. And if you're gonna slow down the Oregon offense, you keep them on the sideline. That's the way to do it.
Last year, USC had about 37 minutes time of possession in the game. Oregon still ran 10 more plays than USC. But every time you have the football, as you noted, if you're USC, that means Oregon's offense does not, and not a chance for them to get on the field and score.
First down and 10 after the 18-yard gain. Silas Red trying to pick a spot, breaks a tackle. Red lowers his shoulder and gets close to the first down. Smash mouth football early on for SC.
And these are the types of plays they'll have to make all game long. Look at the support he gets here. But really, Silas Red made the play. Look at that. In the hole, he's going to make two misses right there. And Alonso's a good tackler. He misses. Himuli missed also. Michael Clay misses. Another good tackler at linebacker. To win this game, the top playmakers for USC have to make their normal plays and then a few extra.
Picks up 10 yards. Here's a handoff. Silas Red. And he goes down. Second down at 8 of the 26. Here's Barkley in trouble. And gets it away. Matt Barkley clobbered as he released the football.
And that was Deion Jordan, number 96, who came to the game questionable with a bad shoulder. Hurt it against Colorado. He hurt his ankle last year and only played part of the first quarter at Oregon. And his lack of pass rushing skills hurt Oregon's defense against USC. Today, he's going to work mainly from his right, USC's left, against Max Turk, a true freshman left tackle. Deion Jordan likes that matchup.
Third down and 8 at the 26. Marquise Lee, the receiver at the top of your screen. Robert Woods at the bottom. He's great on crossing routes. And they throw to the sideline. Caught by Jalen Cope Fitzpatrick. But he doesn't have enough for the first down. So a decision has to be made now for Lane Kiffin, and he's bringing on the field goal. 6 of 9. Didn't attempt one last week at Arizona. This one from 39 yards away. Up. And perfect. Welcome back. 7-3. Our score. Oregon scoring on their opening drive. SC with the field goal. Matt Barkley, no problems marching his team down the field. They stalled a little bit when they got close to the red zone. This one sailing in the end zone again. So they're not going to give DeAnthony Thomas an opportunity to run one back. First down and 10 at the 25. Kenyon Barner in the backfield. And he'll run it left. Now Oregon
You said something interesting on their first drive. You said they scored in reverse. What did you mean?
Meaning Oregon's a heavy run team first. They may be a spread team, but all spread teams aren't built to throw the football first. Oregon is spreading it to run it. But on the first drive, they went at their normal hyperspeed, or blur speed as they call it, but they threw the ball far more than they ran it. I think they caught USC a little bit off guard on the first drive.
Mariota over the middle and caught. And this time it's Hawkins with the reception. Darrell Hawkins, the junior. As you take a look at the run pass decisions by Oregon, remember they average 330 yards rushing per game, third in the nation.
Just a little bit over 200 yards passing.
They run it. Barner trying to get outside and does. And Barner finally knocked out of bounds by Nikhil Roby after a gain of about four.
This seems like a small thing, but it's a big thing for USC. Lamar Dawson, number 55, middle linebacker, had a chance to tackle Barner initially. Okay, so he doesn't break a big play, but he puts it in second and manageable instead of making it second and seven or more.
On second and five, Mariota in trouble, scrambles. He's got space. And he's got wheels, gets out of bounds, picks up the first. That's what makes this kid so dangerous as a redshirt freshman.
And he gets help from his wide receivers. These are not your wide receivers who are the divas that only catch footballs. These are wide receivers that will block and fight all the time to extend the running game. Josh Huff gave an escort to Mariota on the sideline to pick up the first down.
First down, they'll pitch it. Barner with a blocker in front of him. Barner gets down the sideline and finally goes out after another first down close to the 15. Gerald Bowman pushing him out of bounds.
And while it may look exotic because Oregon's going so fast, these plays are standard plays that can be found in anyone's playbook. Tosses, counters, traps, but they go so fast it's hard to be ready to defend them.
Mariota to throw it. Mariota sacked in the backfield. Backside pressure being applied by USC, and it's Wes Horton, the senior.
And to get that, that meant they had to get coverage in the secondary. Look at USC now locking up. Murphy, number 89, trying to break free. Nothing there for Mariota, which allows Horton to come from the backside and try and cause a fumble. See him trying to go for the strip?
No sacks last week against Arizona for the Trojans. Second and 15. And they dump it off. Huff. Josh Huff. Touchdown Oregon. .453 to play in the first quarter. And the Ducks with a chance to take a 14-3 lead. Rob Beard. Extra point good. As you take a look at this Oregon scoring drive, 9 plays, 75 yards. Scoring in 3 minutes and 11 seconds. Mariota off to a great start, 6 of 6, 103 yards and a touchdown. And under Chip Kelly, Maldonado sends it away. Marquise Lee will start inside his own 5. And Marquise Lee gets across the 30 up to the 33. Trojans start from their own 32. Robert Woods in motion. Matt Markman going up top. And a beautiful throw. Marquise Lee camping under and gets out of bounds after a 15-yard pickup.
And it looked like it was headed for at least an incompletion. Look at Tyson Coleman. He even got a finger on it. And Marquise Lee, with concentration, catches the tip ball, gets the foot down, and USC picks up a first down.
So a first down at the 48. Lee, the All-America sophomore, with 300 yards receiving last week against Arizona. Barkley up top. He's got a receiver. Aguilar. First down, SC. Eric Dargan brings him down, but Nelson Aguilar gains 34 yards.
And look up here. This is a free release. There are no hands on the receiver, no rerouting. He just takes off and goes, and he's working against Avery Patterson, normally a safety, a former cornerback. Easy release for Aguilar, and what a terrific throw by Matt Barkley, putting it in the hole before the safety can come over and make the play.
Barkley will throw it in the end zone. Picked off. Wow. Olamo with the interception.
Take a look. Lee thinks he's being held and gives up on the route. Olamu does not and comes up with the interception.
First down and 10 at the 20-yard line for Oregon after the Ifo Ekwe Olamu interception. And I'm sure that's a play that Marquise Lee will be.
You've got to play through. You've got to play through some things. As great a receiver as he is, he's going to be held.
Mariota in trouble, and they sack him. Second sack of the day for the Trojans at the 22-yard line. Deion Bailey getting to the backfield.
And what he's hoping now, Marquise Lee's hoping, is that his defense can bail him out a little bit. Finish plays as a wide receiver. Don't leave your quarterback and your team hung out by not finishing the route before complaining to the officials. Can the defense pick him up now and save him?
Third down and 9, Mariota. Steps into his throw and has a first down, Josh Huff. And on any other team, Josh Huff would be the number one receiver.
If he could stay healthy, he probably would be for Oregon. His last couple of seasons, he's been dinged. Stress fractures last season, a sprained knee this season. Came into today's game with 9 catches on the year. I believe that's his third now for the game, one of them going for a touchdown.
4 catches, 49 yards last week.
Yes.
In their blowout win against Colorado on first down. Kenyon Varner straight ahead, picks up 4. Morgan Breslin, the junior college transfer, with the tackle.
And what Josh Huff also gives you is that run after catch ability, a high school running back and quarterback. Stoutly built, can be a game breaker.
Second and 6. Mariota pitches, fumble. Out of bounds, the Anthony Thomas slipped out of his hands.
And the only reason that happened is the quarterback running back ratio and pitch got cut down. Normally it's a little more distance. As he was running to the corner, that got closer. And when he pitched it to him, it came at him harder than he's used to seeing it.
First down inside SC territory. Barner looking. And Morgan Breslin stops him, but he gains 4. Not your typical 4 yards in a cloud of dust.
No. It's 4 yards in a blur of feet normally for Oregon. Even on a 4-yard gain, you're holding your breath wondering if they're going to slip out of that pile.
Second down and 5 as we come to the end of the first quarter. The pitch, Barner. First down.
Zone running team. We talked about how Chip Kelly likes speed at every position. A lighter offensive line that's mobile. You see them all stepping to the left, almost on a track together to get out to the corner and give that to their running back. They condition by the way they practice full speed every day.
First down and 10 at the 32. Now Mariota running up the sideline and out of bounds. Beautiful shot at downtown LA. Our score right here, 14-3. Oregon with 203 yards of total offense in the first quarter. 86 yards rushing. Second and 5 of the 27. Mariota underneath. Oh, almost picked off. Lamar Dawson, if he could have held on, he had a touchdown in front of him.
And what's difficult for USC is this is a nice play by Dawson, 55. Watch him move to the football. And what's nice is the play, but what's not nice is he didn't finish it off. Last time USC got a sack on Mariota, the very next play, they threw a touchdown pass.
Third down and 5 at the 27. They hand it off. Barner with a first down and more. Pops it outside to the corner. Kenyon Barner, touchdown, Oregon. 27 yards.
Mm-hmm.
opportunity must be taken advantage of, because if you don't get the interception and you give them extra plays, this is what Oregon does. Look at the blocking. He's not pressed at all until he gets inside the 5-yard line, and he runs through the tackle by Juwanza Starling and puts it in the end zone for the third time today for Oregon.
And the extra point by Beard is good. Kenyon Barner has rushed for 100 yards in four consecutive games. He has 90 yards on 10 carries, and we just started the second quarter as he capped off the 10-play drive with the 27-yard run to get into the end zone.
Last year in Eugene, USC built up a 24-point lead into the third quarter. They were the ones out in front. Tonight, they'll be the ones doing the chasing.
Marquise Lee lets it go over his head and into the end zone. From the 25, Matt Barkley, 8 of 12, 82 yards. He'll throw it all the way down. Marquise Lee! Punt! Marquise Lee! Touchdown, SC! 75 yards!
Take a look at the defense out on the corner against Marquise Lee. Ekpreolamu fell down on the jam, and Dargan overran the play coming over as Lee got inside of him. USC's offensive line gave Barkley plenty of time to let that route develop, and he hits Lee in stride for a huge play for USC.
Extra point by Hadari is good. SC. With the big play from Marquise Lee, 75 yards. He now has his 10th career 100-yard game. Three catches, 100 and a touchdown. And you get the feeling, folks, we're just getting started here in L.A. Hadari will send it away. Back-to-back touchbacks for Andre Hadari. This time, the Black Mamba brings it out. And DeAnthony Thomas goes down at the... make it the 22-yard line. And five plays, 75 yards. Nine plays, 75 yards. 10 play, 80 yards for touchdowns. Barner breaking tackles again. Kenyon Barner in SC territory, out of bounds at the 30. Juwanza Starling there, but it's a gain of 41.
I played for a coach who used to say a lost opportunity is never regained. Okay, Wes Horton, number 96 for USC. Here's an opportunity right there. Now what does it turn into? Missed the opportunity, missed the tackle. 30-plus yards later.
On first down, DeAnthony Thomas this time. Thomas running downhill. And Thomas tackled inside the 20.
You see that next play philosophy continue to show up for Oregon.
First down at the SC 18. Here's the pitch. And knifing in Deion Bailey. As he stops DeAnthony Thomas before he can get started.
And for USC, their hybrid players have to make those plays. Deion Bailey, Hayes Pollard, guys who look like strong safeties but play as linebackers. TJ McDonald, the strong safety, who can come up and play like a linebacker. Those are the players who have to make plays for USC.
A loss of six, second and 16. Play fake. Mariota winds up. Mariota underneath, and he has his receiver, Thomas, at the 10-yard line. About 3.5 yards short of a first down.
You see the versatility of DeAnthony Thomas, running back, slot receiver. He can do it all.
Mariota. Near side, caught by Will Murphy, and Murphy picks up a first down. TJ McDonald, Hayes, Pilar combining on the tackle.
Doesn't this remind you a little bit of Princeton offense and basketball, Gus? With everyone available to touch the ball and make a play. Will Murphy had 9 catches on the season prior to that one.
Make a second down and goal at the 5. Barner looking to get to the corner, and does. Man. Are they this good?
They are. And they're letting the nation know as this goes on Now, long way to go. USC, we've seen with their quick strike capability, we saw it on the last possession, they come back and score in one or two plays. So they're long from being out of the woods, but they are that good.
And the extra point blocked. All right, Oregon successful on every drive. Kenyon Barner with two touchdowns. Who's that guy standing next to him? He looks familiar.
Yeah, he wore number 21 for Oregon last year and kept Kenyon Barner from gaining more yards. That's LaMichael James. Open week for the San Francisco 49ers. He's been inactive every game so far for the 49ers. They're so loaded at running back. You must be loaded if you can't find a spot for LaMichael James to play for you.
Marquise Lee starts from the 2-yard line. And Lee making people miss. Marquise Lee going down at around the 22. From the 36. Red. And Red keeps his feet. Stumbles forward close to the first down. Avery Patterson grabbed his ankle.
And if he doesn't hook that, Silas Red's ankle, he might have run for big yardage on that play. Patterson coming up from the safety position, got just enough of him to throw it off. Otherwise, he's got Khalid Holmes, his center, out in front as a lead and possibly still stepping towards the end zone.
Both teams racking up major yardage per play. Second and one at the 45. Red again, first down. And he'll get to the 40. A 15-yard gain for Silas Red.
And one thing about being a play caller is you've got to put your ego aside. What did Lane Kiffin do on the last two plays? He's seen something that's working for him. Gets a nice gain from Red, comes right back with a similar play call to the same side of the line of scrimmage and another first down run.
From the Oregon 40, Vanuku and McNeil line up in the offset eye. They give it to McNeil with space. Curtis McNeil still turning. And McNeil down at the 20.
That's three straight big runs for the offensive line of USC. Watch these big fellas working, especially to this side of the line of scrimmage. That's Abe Markowitz, 50. 75 is Max Turk. Yes, Soma Vanuku, 31, the fullback getting out. Robert Woods, the wide receiver, doing a nice job. Don't forget Randall Telfer, number 82, at tight end. Sealed the end and allowed him to get to the corner.
A 20-yard gain, first down and 10 at the 20. Barkley over the middle, caught. Lee picks up the first down at the 9. A 12-yard gain on third and 11.
And Gus, the decisions you don't have to make as a play caller are your favorite ones. You don't have to worry about fourth down now. And you remember what I said earlier about Marquise Lee, that you have to play through some things, you have to play through some contact. On the touchdown he scored, he ran over Ekpre Olomo. On this one, he runs through the jam, doesn't worry about the contact, and picks up the first down. That's what you have to do as an elite receiver. You're going to be in contact all game long. You can't let them hold you and frustrate you.
First down and goal, the 9-yard line for the Trojans. 10th play of the drive. It started at the 23. Here's a handoff. Red straight ahead. And he'll get maybe a yard past the line of scrimmage.
You know what this defense reminds me of in a sense, if I'm going to make a pro analogy?
Mm-hmm.
The Colts defense with Peyton Manning. Built to play with 14-point leads. Put pressure on you. Blitz you. Show you a lot of different looks. Not sure how they do if you grind it out, if you can have that opportunity, but I don't often have to face that. Always playing with a lead.
Barkley pumping, looking. Barkley in trouble. Barkley. Flag on the play in the corner. Caught. Robert Woods. But hold everything. It's a touchdown. But what's the flag?
I saw it come from.
Prior to the pass being thrown, holding defense number 27. Penalties declined, touchdown stands.
Because here's where the hold occurs. Take a look at Terrence Mitchell, number 27. That's where the flag came in, holding Nelson Aguilar. but the play was extended for Barkley, and he finds Woods for the touchdown.
So with 5 minutes and 59 seconds remaining in the second quarter, SC down 27-17. SC cuts it to 10. Adari has done a nice job on touchbacks. This time, DeAnthony Thomas gets one more opportunity. And DeAnthony Thomas taken down after he crosses the 15. Kenyon Barner putting up huge numbers. They get it to DeAnthony Thomas. Thomas running straight ahead as he submarines down in front of Deion Bailey, close to the first down.
I think about this Oregon offense. I think about something Monty Kiffin said to us early in the year, Gus. When you have to read your keys against teams that move this fast, he told us, see a little, see a lot. If you see a lot, you see nothing. Meaning you got to down focus, read your keys, get clean on what you're seeing, not see the whole big picture, and let all the intricacies affect your play.
Mariota running. Mariota with a first down. Watch out. He's got blazing speed. Mariota all the way down inside the SC 15. Nickel Roby tracked him down after a 57-yard gain.
Now let's see if they see a little or see a lot. See the fake there? They saw too much. All these guys were looking here. Instead, Mariota sees the gap and he's gone.
Now he throws it. Mariota, touchdown, Oregon, Darrell Hawkins. When Darren Thomas elected to enter the NFL draft, collectively the nation scratched our heads. We said, well, who's Chip Kelly gonna replace him with?
You know, there's a school of thought in Eugene that Darren Thomas saw this young man in his rear view, which helped him make his decision, because he saw him all of last year. And Brian Bennett, who played for Darren Thomas last year, is a quality quarterback too. Marcus Mariota is without a doubt the real deal.
Three plays, 81 yards. They scored in 50 seconds.
Received it now.
Lee from the four. And Marquise Lee will get to the 20. So with 2:49 remaining, the Trojans would love to go into the locker room down by only 10. Play fake. Barkley throws a home run again. Aguilar! Oh my goodness! The freshman, Nelson Aguilar! Touchdown, Trojans! What a catch! 76 yards! Woo!
We saw the eyes of Matt Barkley on the Phantom Cam. How about there? A clean pocket, perfect sight lines, and Aguilar knows the hits coming from inside, focuses and puts the ball away, and that's a coming out party for the freshman. They've been looking to develop the third receiver all year long. Nelson Aguilar stepping into the breach this evening.
2:37 to go. Here in the second quarter, we've got a good old-fashioned shootout.
How about the USC defense standing firm and giving them an opportunity? Watch Aguilar in the slot. Deion Jordan rushes. Now he goes. Look at Terrence Mitchell. See him grab him right there? That could have been a flag. He ran through it, played through it, didn't look to the official to try and get help. Focused on the football, ran through the trash, and ends up in the end zone.
34-24, our halftime score. Gus Johnson along with Charles Davis, CD.
Woo!
Close to 900 yards in total offense for these teams in the first half. And the most interesting thing is USC could be leading this game.
They could be. Marcus Mariota, the freshman quarterback, was superb in the first half. Save a fumble. Matt Barkley, tremendous, playing like a senior Heisman Trophy candidate. But boy, we needed an oxygen tank trying to keep up with all the yardage and points as this game progressed.
And that was our four-game summary. So, as we start the second half, Southern California will have the football. Remember, they deferred in the first half. What do you expect to see from both these teams, CD?
Well, frankly, I think USC, their game plan is starting to work. defense continues to fight, forced some turnovers, and didn't allow points. They've got to continue in that vein. For Oregon, I think defensively is where they're having the issue. Offense hasn't been a problem at all. But defensively, they've got to find a way to get in Matt Barkley's face, not respect the running game as much for USC, and go after the quarterback.
Oregon to kick off to start the second half. Marquise Lee back deep. And this is Lee who fumbles it. Picks it up at the 10. Lee gets to the 30. Still running, Marquise Lee. Finally wrapped up at the 35-yard line. Now let's go downstairs where our Julie Alexandria had a chance to meet up with Chip Kelly.
Coach, over 400 yards of total offense in the first half, 5 touchdowns for you guys. What do you have to do to keep that momentum going in the second half?
We got to obviously continue to score on offense, but we got to stop, you know, Barkley and Woods and Lee, 3 great players, so it's going to be a hell of a second half for
them. Seems like they're taking every opportunity to take advantage of what you guys are giving them, so how do you contain them?
We got to tackle them when they're in open space, and we got to make some plays on the ball when it's in the air.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
First down at 10 at the 35. For Matt Barkley, lining up in the gun, Robert Woods in motion. Here's Barkley, caught on his knees. Marquise Lee, first down, SC. Can this kid get any better?
Oh, certainly. And where he's going to get better is what we talked about in the first half. Quit officiating the game as you play. You know, you remember the first interception with, MK Olomo? He wanted a flag. Finish the play. After that play, remember the rest of the half? He finished the play. And if he does that, he's hard to contain.
Barkley in trouble. Gets it away to Bielenko. And incomplete. A lot of pressure on Matt Barkley. But his pocket presence, we saw it on that play.
He's not a player that's going to get out of the pocket and beat you running it. But his footwork in the pocket, slide steps, finding the gaps, finding the seams to throw the football, saved him from a sack on that play. Deion Jordan, who came into the game with a bad right shoulder, goes out of the game now to get some attention. But Nic Aliotti, notice he did? He rolled the dice and said, I'm betting on a first down pass, and sent all out pressure at Matt Barkley.
Second down and 10. Barkley to the sideline. Robert Woods. Terrence Mitchell with the tackle. But Woods with a 14-yard gain.
Woods cutting inside, gets the hand down for balance. Before Mitchell comes back to secure the tackle after Woods runs a nice route to free himself for the first down.
First down at the 21. Oregon showing blitz. Here they come. Here's a handoff. Red. Silas Red. Another positive run, this time for 7 yards. Michael Clay with the tackle. And I know our colleague Marcus Allen, one of the greats of all time, who played at SC, is watching USC run the ball, and he's thinking of the old days.
Loving it, because what they're doing is they're seeing the pressure coming from Nic Aliotti, and Lane Kiffin has made an adjustment now. You want to come at me on first down thinking I'm going to throw it? I'll run it into the teeth of the blitz, and if you miss me as you go by, I'm going to gain good positive yardage on my carries.
Second down and 3, Vianuku, and Red, here's Red again. Wow, this SC team starting to really play some physical football. Turk, Marcus Martin, the left guard. Colin Holmes, John Martinez, the right guard. Kevin Graff, the right tackle, are blowing guys off the line of scrimmage.
And then you throw in the tight ends, Randall Telfer, 82, Xavier Grimble, 86. And then, of course, up front, Soma Vanuku or Jaleel Pinner, the fullbacks. Now you're starting to get some. You asked about confidence earlier about Oregon. Will they have a confidence thing? To me, the confidence is rising for USC on offense and how they're running the football.
First down and goal at the 2. Opening drive of the second half of the Trojans. Silas Red! We got a ball game, folks, in L.A. 9:59 to go.
SC with a chance to cut it to three. Extra point good. Welcome back, USC, who's trailed by as many as 18 in this game when the score was 21-3. Scores on the opening drive of the second half. 11 plays, 65 yards. Silas Red punches it in. And with 9:59 to go in the third, we've got a three-point ball game. The momentum on the side of the Trojans.
Oregon now has to start putting points on the board. Before, it was a little bit easier.
Adari kicks this one deep into the end zone. And Oregon will start from the 25. Hands it off, Kenyon Barner. And Kenyon Barner popping it through over the 40, a gain of 16. Barner on his way to 200 yards rushing. He's got 185.
This crowd wants to fully get with USC right now. Their defense has to give them a reason to go ahead and go all out. They can't let it be that easy on a first down run.
On first down, here's Huff. Makes a first man miss. Huff finally tracked down inside the 30 by Hayes Pollard. And we talked to Lane Kiffin about his team being able to tackle in space. He said it's the most important aspect of this game for his defense.
And how many times have we seen missed tackles in space? There was Leonard Williams, and it's really unfair. You talk about defensive tackle on his feet in space, trying to take out a scat back wide receiver, and he was unsuccessful.
First down, Mariota pumping, looking, throws, and it whizzed this one out of the end zone. Very good decision by the freshman.
Very intelligent play in the pocket, realizing that play was over. He was out of time. Throws it out of the back of the end zone. Live to fight another down without giving up the sack yardage.
Mariota, a four-star recruit, rated the number 12 overall quarterback in the nation while at St. Louis High School in Honolulu. 12th play of the drive. It started at the 25. They'll pitch it out. Barner turns it up. And Kenyon Barner goes down at the 10.
And I've seen USC on this drive trying to get substitutes in and out of the game now, trying to combat the tempo that Oregon brings to them. Remember, they gave up 94 plays on defense against Arizona.
Barner again breaks it. Barner, end zone, touchdown. Oregon responds. SC unable to get lined up.
This is how they out-tempo you. Watch USC's defense. Oregon's getting set, ready to go. Where's USC? Are we lined up? Do we go there? Where do we go? And then another missed tackle in the backfield by Lamar Dawson, and Barner goes into the end zone. When you say Heisman Trophy discussion, you better put Kenyon Barner into your discussion group.
Rob Beard. Extra point, good. And the Ducks back up by 10. Welcome back. 5:14 to go in the third quarter. 10-point ball game. Over 1,000 yards of total offense between these two teams. Marquise Lee, Nelson Aguilar back deep. Here's Lee from the two. Lee with a lane. Marquise Lee down the sideline. Marquise Lee sprinting out of bounds inside the 20.
Now this is blocked well by USC special teams, but you tend to block better when you know you have a game breaker. Look at that. Aguilar marries up right there on the block. Look at the block here, block here. Now you're giving a guy with incredible gifts an opportunity. And what does he do? Makes two Oregon Ducks miss before finally getting corralled deep downfield by number 13, Troy Hill.
An 82-yard return for Marquise Lee. First down at the Oregon 16 for the Trojans. The handoff to Silas Red. And Red dives forward. Picks up three. Iannuku in at tailback. With Jaleel Pinner, the upback. Robert Woods in motion. Iannuku trying to pound it. And Oregon all over the play. Great pressure by the Oregon defense. And that'll bring up a third down and eight.
And for both defenses and for Oregon's offensive line, it's almost like a hockey game. You're rotating people in and out. It's like a shift. Everybody over the board, you rotate in, substitute people in because of the pace of this game. Trying to get some rest and some fresh legs and fresh bodies on the field for each and every snap.
They're shifting on the fly. Third down and 8. Lee back in the game. On the run, Marquise Lee. First down, SC. As he hops down inside the 5, Terrence Mitchell with the tackle. But on 3rd and 8, Trojans get 12. And now it's first down and goal near the 2-yard line.
In the first half, they used Marquise Lee out of the backfield to hide him. Now they use him in motion. How does Marquise Lee get off the line of scrimmage and have no white shirts near him? That makes zero sense, doesn't it? As a defensive coordinator, he's one of the guys you star, circle, and put a spotlight on in your game plan.
Big game for Lee. They spot it at the 3-yard line. Second down and goal, the pitch. Silas Ray, smell it, Peyton. And he's in. What a game. 2:32 to go. Third quarter, 41-37. First 1-60 wins.
That might be conservative at the rate we're going. But the extra offensive lineman helped provide the avenue to the end zone for Silas Gray.
Extra point good.
About that touchdown play. Lane Kiffin, a little imagination, took his left tackle and flipped him to the right side, put him in a slot position almost like a receiver, and brought in another tackle to play the backside.
Adari. This is the Anthony Thomas will bring it out of the end zone. And Thomas trying to get started. And out of bounds, a 27-yard return. From the 26, here's the toss. Barner gets down the sideline. Nice stiff arm. And he'll gain close to 10 yards on the play. You got to compliment this Oregon offensive line. They've made some changes up front for this game.
They end up getting an injury. Mona Gregg, who had started the last two games, couldn't play tonight. So they move Ryan Clanton from left guard to right guard and put Kyle Long to start the game at left guard, normally a tackle.
Kyle Long, the son of our colleague at Fox, Howie Long, who's in attendance. We saw him at the hotel today. He looked calm.
Poor dad. For a dad, as you know, he's been through it before. He's got his son Chris, who's a Pro Bowl defensive end for the St. Louis Rams.
There he is.
Got Howie Jr., who's a terrific lacrosse player at Virginia.
Second and 4, Barner again. First down and more. Barner out of bounds. He couldn't stay in. Anthony Sorrow nudged him, but it's a gain of 21.
And the athletic offensive line of Oregon keeps providing answers when USC presses them. They keep finding creases and holes and open up avenues for running backs to sprint through.
Byron Marshall comes in for Barner in the backfield. Play fake. Mariota up the seam. Touchdown. Josh Huff. His second of the day. 36 yards.
And that ball could not have been thrown any better than the redshirt freshman from Hawaii just did. Take a look, because now you've got a slot with a linebacker, Deion Bailey. And he's looking into the backfield and doesn't really run. I'm not sure if he thinks Juwan Starling is supposed to take him, but he doesn't really run with the receiver.
Extra point good. 1:19 to play in the third. This kid, Marcus Mariota, has been perfect.
Here's Marquise Lee.
Outside. And Lee tackled at the 25. First down and 10 for the Trojans at their own 25. Barkley drops it off to his tight end, Grimble. And Grimble picks up 3. Terrence Mitchell chopping down the big tight end. 6'5", 260 for Xavier.
Now, this half to me has been more of a USC chopping wood on offense, continuing to progress, putting the ball in the end zone, but it takes a little while. Then Oregon gets the football back, sprint, it's in the end zone the other way. The pressure stays on USC to continue to score, but they have to do it the hard way.
Second and seven. Barkley. Caught by Marquise Lee. And a first down for the Trojans. Kiko Alonso stops it. As we close in on the end of the third quarter, SC, the preseason number one team in the nation, lost at Stanford. Started to make a comeback, got in the top 10 last week at Arizona, up by 15 late, and they lose the game. Lane Kiffin knows that with Oregon in town and Notre Dame later on during the season, this team has a chance to rally. We head to the fourth.
You see how Oregon sprinted out to the 14-3 lead, but look how USC has rallied back.
Gus Johnson, Charles Davis, Julie Alexandria, second and six for Matt Barkley. And Barkley looking underneath for Robert Woods. And Oregon jumping on him quickly brings up third down and six.
Look at this, 12 touchdowns, zero punts in this game. And really hasn't been an opportunity for a coach to really think about punting. But this third down, key for Oregon's defense, trying to find a way to get off the field for the first time this half against USC's offense.
Robert Woods, the receiver at the bottom of your screen. Third down and six at the 42. Barkley over the middle, almost intercepted, incomplete. And we may see our first punt of the game.
No choice really to me for Lane Kiffin. This side of the field, the way Oregon moves the football, you have to punt it and hope your defense can hold up and make them go the long way. But the delayed rush by Kiko Alonso, number 47, helped get into the face of Matt Barkley and helped force the incompletion.
Kyle Negrete standing at the 27. The Anthony Thomas, the Black Mamba, at his own 13. Negrete, end over end kick. And it takes a USC box. Downed at the 15. They've been playing this series since 1915. The Oregon offense, folks, with 626 total yards, most ever by a USC opponent, and we just started the fourth quarter. Kenyon Barner has 250 yards rushing. This is Mariota. Marcus Mariota also running the ball extremely well. 14 carries, 88 yards prior to that play. He gained nine.
And that's the dimension they really didn't have last year with Darren Thomas, who didn't run the ball with nearly the frequency that we're seeing out of Mariota.
Second down is short. They need a yard. And they hand it off. First down, Oregon. At the 27. Barner again over the right side. Picking his way free and picks up another first down.
You know, we've seen Kansas State a few times this year. When we talk about the patience and running of Colin Klein, their terrific quarterback. I see the exact same thing with Kenyon Barner. Patience, vision. Waits for a play to form. He waited for a block from Jake Fisher, number 75, and was rewarded when Fisher buried the USC deep defender and allowed Barner to access downfield.
Barner straight ahead this time. Another first down. Swiss cheese defense for USC. Jawanza Starling finally with the tackle. But you got to give a lot of credit to this Oregon offensive line as well.
Look at this. Most ever yards by USC opponent. 275, three touchdowns, and a long way to go for Kenyon Barnum. USC's defense is in the danger zone now, needing to force a big play.
They get it out to DeAnthony Thomas. And DeAnthony inside the SC 40, picks up 13. So they've gained 9, 3, 13, 9, and another 13 on this drive.
And they're just so relentless, right back on the line of scrimmage and right back at you.
Here's the hitch to Lowe. And Lowe picks up about 8.5. Bailey with the tackle.
And another good decision by Mariota. That was designed to be a big strike downfield. Fake the screen, throw one deep, realized it wasn't there, came back to the screen and put it on low.
This kid is unflappable. Second and 2 at the 30. Barner. First down.
And here comes USC, running linemen and substitutes onto the field. If you're a hockey coach, you say, change it up. Over the boards, here they come. Trying to get some guys some rest and get other guys on the field, some fresh people, against this offensive attack of Oregon that does not stop.
First down at the 26. And they'll run it. This time it's Byron Marshall, freshman from San Jose.
Yeah, he's only run for 125 yards in a game already this year himself against Tennessee Tech.
Gained a yard, second and 9.
You know who's been quiet tonight is Colt Wierla, number 15, the tight end. Haven't seen much from him. Always a big play waiting to happen.
Marshall. Gang tackled, and that'll bring up a third down after the 5-yard pickup.
You know he's coming back on the field for Oregon on this key third down, don't you?
Kenyon Barnum. They'll throw it. Looking for Barner, and have him in the flats. Barner breaks a tackle and gets inside the 10.
How about Mariota in the pocket? Watch his progressions. Left, center, middle, then throws it out to the right. Great vision and sighting by Marcus Mariota for another big first down.
First down and goal at the 9-yard line. Barner outside and tackled from behind. They had to track him down, but it took a while as Burnett missed the first tackle but managed to come back and clean it up. Second down and goal at the 5-yard line. Here's a handoff. Barner outside. Touchdown Oregon, his fourth touchdown of the game. And you just wonder, CD, with all the talent that USC has on defense, these players that you see on this SC team will be playing, many of them, in the NFL. Your point is good. 54-38. Make that 55-38 now. See their defense over the last 2 weeks, given up over 1,300 yards, 714 this evening, 588 last week at Arizona. Marquise Lee inside his own 5. And Lee trying to break another one, and he'll get out of bounds at the 45. First down and 10 at the 40. Barkley pumping, delivers. Lee, the intended receiver,
That one thrown high.
See the strain on the face of Terrence Mitchell. Wanting the interception. And also, it's been a long night for the Oregon secondary, too, dealing with the All-American receivers that USC throws at them on every snap.
Second and 10. Barkley dumps it off McNeil. He's got room. McNeil stumbling forward and finally dropped at the 25 after a first down. A 15-yard pickup.
Goal of screen passes is to use your aggression against you. Oregon brought some pressure, dumped it short inside, and McNeil gets upfield.
Now Barkley to Aguilar. He turns it up. Nelson Aguilar with a stiff arm and finally tripped up by Eric Dargan, but he'll gain 18.
Seeing a freshman really grow up in front of our eyes tonight, aren't we, partner?
Huge game for Nelson Aguilar. Four catches, 135 yards, and a touchdown. Barkley rolling out of the pocket, throws, and touchdown. Randall Telfer. USC refusing to go away. 5:27 to play in the fourth. And how often in college football, or football in general, you say we scored 45 points and lost? This game has just changed.
Remember West Virginia Baylor this year, 70-63, and Baylor lost.
USC showing onside kick. Can they get it?
The ball was out of bounds, therefore the ball is Oregon's first down and 10.
Look at Roby. Boy, now Lane Kiffin used a challenge earlier that was unsuccessful. Remember that. He challenged a play that was unsuccessful on the challenge. He would love for the booth to look at that again.
So the Ducks take over close to midfield. Hand it off to Barner. And Barner goes down, inbounds. And this is Lane Kiffin's reaction to the call.
You can tell he came up with a real thought and composed himself as a head coach. And now Oregon, look at the play clock, 17, 16. Now they're going to start to milk it a little bit and run their offense.
Barner. Third and three at the 44. They pitch it to Barner. He juggled it. And he won't pick up the first down.
See, now after the loss, you think about punting it away if you're Chip Kelly. If it was fourth and real short, I think he'd try and go for it. But the bobble on the start threw up the timing of the play. And look at the swarm by USC. Dawson there first, TJ McDonald, Leonard Williams, Hayes Pillard.
Here. Robert Woods back deep. Jackson Rice at the 38. Bounds. First down and 10 at the 15. 3:35 remaining in the fourth for Matt Barkley. Do or die time for the Trojans. Barkley scrambling, throws across his body, incomplete. Pocket breaking down. Marquise Lee, the intended receiver.
True freshman DeForest Buckner, number 44. Get off the line of scrimmage. Excellent pass rush. Push the pocket back into the face of Barkley. Help force the incompletion. First down, they just rush four and drop seven with a 10-point lead.
Barkley short drop underneath. Robert Woods dodged forward, gets to the 20. Kiko Alonso stops him. 400-yard day for Matt Barkley, fourth time in his career. Third and five. Down by 10. Barkley to the sideline. Aguilar drops it. First mistake of the game for this young man. He had the first down as well. So that brings up fourth down and five.
He picked a heck of a time to show that he was a freshman, because we hadn't seen it all game long, had we?
Not at all. USC has to go for it. Time not on their side. Marquise Lee in the backfield. Barkley, incomplete. And USC turns it over on down.
And Nic Aliotti, the D coordinator, said, forget playing coverage. Watch the pressure, right? Watch everybody coming to him. And now what? They covered everyone else. And even the nose tackle, Taylor Hart, dropped into zone coverage, and I think that fooled him a little bit. Normally he would rush. He dropped and took away the middle zone. Alonso, a really nice job shadowing Woods. Look at the coverage there. Aguilar can't get open. Well done by the Oregon defense.
Oregon now at the SC 20-yard line. Barner. And the Ducks will not be in a hurry. Lamar Dawson with the tackle. So let's take a look at the road ahead for teams chasing the BCS title game.
Well, if you're Alabama, if you handle LSU, and last report we got, they were up 14-3.
Oregon messing up our broadcast. Get to the line of scrimmage so quickly. Barner running. Hayes Ballard with the tackle. Huge day for Kenyon Barner. Prior to that, run 37 carries, 295 yards. Four touchdowns.
You don't want to see him take a loss here for the record's purpose, right? Drop down below 300.
You hand it to him, he won't take a loss at all. Kenyon Barner again. That's number five. Kenyon Barner with 322 yards rushing. Five touchdowns.
They wear you down physically, but they also wear you down mentally, because they keep you thinking at an extremely fast rate all game long. And after a while, it's hard for those synapses to keep coming together and figuring out what to do. And he waltzes into the end zone.
Great kickout block on that touchdown run by Kyle Long. And I'm sure that's going to make one man in particular in the building very happy.
Talk about Steve Greatwood, the offensive line coach.
Watch Kyle Long. '74 was at the top of your screen.
I remember that year well. We played against Reuben Mays. My Tennessee team played against Reuben Mays and that Washington State team. Mark Griffin was quarterbacking. They came to Knoxville and we outlasted them that night.
So SC will get the ball at the 35, the minute and 52 to go. And Barkley complete to Marquise Lee as Kiko Alonso slings him to the turf. Barkley tipped and caught. Aguilar, and they give him the catch at the 36.
Well, Seeing some good concentration tonight. There's the tip. And how about Aguilar seeing it and carrying it, catching it for a first down?
A 21-yard gain. Barkley in trouble, and Matt Barkley going down. Taylor Hart getting into the backfield, and that is a sack for Hart.
I mean, that when you talk about a jailbreak to the quarterback. Taylor Hart was there almost about the time Barkley got the ball. He tried to unload and get rid of it, but Jay Strickerts called him in the grasp and down before he unloaded the pass.
First sack of the night for Oregon. Aguilar juking, can't get out of bounds. And the clock continues to run with 40 seconds remaining in this one. Oregon got off to the big start, up 21-3. USC rallied, eventually cut this game to a 3-point football game in the second half. But the big story, the Trojans just with no answers for Chip Kelly and the Oregon offense. Kenyon Barner, 300 yards rushing. And their young quarterback in Eugene is a cool customer.
I think what USC was counting on, can we put the pressure on them, and could the young quarterback handle it? Well, remember, as you noted, it was 34-31, third quarter. And Oregon kept answering on offense. And that was led by the quarterback, Mariota. And then finally, the defense got a couple of stops, which helped extend the lead to where we are now.
Fourth down and three, and this ball is caught by Robert Woods. Woods running, hurtling. Woods trying to get to the end zone and out of bounds at about the two. Robert Woods with a 28-yard gain, 5 seconds to go.
And I like the fact that the home crowd recognized the effort despite the fact that it's not going to change the final result. That Robert Woods continued to fight and scratch and claw to try and make this thing go to change, even though he knows the final score will not be reflective of it.
First down and goal. 5 seconds to go. In the end zone, Marquise Lee with the touchdown. With a second remaining. Barkley throwing his fifth touchdown pass. 483 yards passing on 35 of 54. Two interceptions.
Did you see that look on Chip Kelly's face? He's going to enjoy the win. But he's got plenty to work with on his team. That's what you kind of want as a head coach. Win the game, but still plenty to say to your team.
1,361 yards of total offense by these two teams. 16 touchdowns. Two-point conversion. Marquise Lee, the intended receiver, incomplete. Kelly now 3-1 against SC. His team remains undefeated. 9-0. 6-0 in the conference. As Oregon wins it 62-51 on the road. Thank you for attending the CB's game. 62-51 the final.